Happy day, students. Today I am going to deal with book bag exercises of 12th standard, unit 3, poem 3, All the World's a Stage, written by William Shakespeare. Dear students, now turn to page 91. We shall see the fill in the blanks using the words given in the brackets. Shakespeare considers the whole world a stage where men and women are only actors. They enter the stage when they are born and exit when they die. Every man during his lifetime plays 7 roles based on age. In the first act, as an infant, he is wholly dependent on the mother or a nurse. Later, emerging as a school child, he slings his bag over his shoulder and creeps most reluctantly to school. His next act is that of a lover, busy composing ballads for his beloved and earns for her attention. In the fourth stage, he is aggressive and ambitious and seeks repetition in all that he does. He promises solemnly to guard his country and becomes a soldier. As he grows older, with maturity and wisdom, he becomes a fair judge. During this stage, he is firm and serious. In the sixth act, he is seen with loose pantaloons and spectacles. His manly voice changes into a childish treble. The last scene of all is his second childhood. Slowly, he loses his faculties of sight, hearing, smell and taste, and exits from the roles of his life. Now, moving on to the next page. From the understanding of the poem, answer the questions. A. What is the world compared to? The world is compared to a stage. B. And they have their exits and their entrances. What do the words exits and entrances mean? Exits mean death and entrance means birth. C. What is the first stage of a human life? Infant stage is the first stage of human life. D. Describe the second stage of life as depicted by Shakespeare. In the second stage, he emerges as a school child. He slings his bag over his shoulder and creeps most reluctantly to school. E. How does a man play a lover's role? As a lover, he is busy composing ballads for his beloved and earns for her attention. F. Bring out the features of the fourth stage of a man as described by the poet. Soldier is the fourth stage. Here man seeks fame, though it is temporary and short-lived. He endangers his life for it, but it is nothing more than a bubble. G. When does a man become a judge? How? In the fifth stage, he becomes a judge. By the time he develops a round belly, he has a formal beard and quotes many proverbs and modern instances. H. Which stage of man's life is associated with the shrunk? In the sixth stage, man's life is associated with the shrunk. I. Why is the last stage called second childhood? The last stage ends the eventful history of man. In this stage, he is like a child without teeth, sight and taste. Now moving on to question 3, page number 92. Explain the following lines with reference to the context. ERC. A. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts. Reference. These lines are taken from All the World's Stage, which is an extract from Shakespeare's As You Like It. Okay, written by William Shakespeare. That's enough. Context. The poet utters these words when he wants to express how man enters the world. Moving on to explanation. In this part, Shakespeare says that the world is a stage. Man enters the stage through his birth. And he leaves the stage through death. In between birth and death, he plays many roles. 7 roles. B. Jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble repetition. Reference. These lines are taken from All the World's Stage, written by William Shakespeare. Context. The poet explains how a soldier would be. Explanation. In this part, Shakespeare says that the world is a stage. Man plays many roles on the stage. These lines explain the fourth stage, that is of a soldier. In this stage, he takes great care of honor and repetition. He is quick to get into any argument. He tries to get repetition, which is as short-lived as a bubble. Moving on to C. His second childishness and mere oblivion, sans teeth, sans eyes, sans taste, sans everything. Reference. These lines are taken from All the World's Stage, written by William Shakespeare. Context. The poet describes the last role of a man in his eventful life. Explanation is very important. In this part, Shakespeare says that the world is a stage. He plays many roles on the stage. These lines explain the last stage of man. In this stage, he becomes like a child, and it is his second childishness. It is the stage of oblivion. He is forgotten by his people. He is without teeth, sight, taste, and everything. Dear students, now move on to page 93 and you can see, 92, and we can see the fourth question. Read the poem once again carefully and identify the figures of speech that has been used in each of the following lines from the poem. A. All the world's a stage. The figure of speech is metaphor. B. And all the men and women merely players. Metaphor. C. And shining morning face creeping like snail. Like is there, no. The figure of speech is simile. D. Full of strange oaths and bearded like the pot. Figure of speech is simile. E. Seeking the bubble repetition. Figure of speech is metaphor. You should write full sentences. Okay. F. His youthful hose well saved a world too wide. This is alliteration. Okay, W, well, world, wide. You have to take the words and write. G, and this big manly voice turning again towards childish treble. It is personification. Moving on to fifth question. Pick out the words in alliteration in the following lines. A, and all the men and women merely players. And all is assonance. Men merely is alliteration. Okay, you should write only men and merely. B, and one man in his time plays many parts. Man, many. You have to underline M. Okay, M sound. C, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel. Quick quarrel. You have to underline QQ. Moving on to sixth one. Read the given lines and answer the questions that follow. Appreciation question A. Then the whining schoolboy with his sachet and shining morning face creeping like snail, unwilling to go to school. Which stage of life is being referred to here by the poet? The second stage, the schoolboy is being referred to here by the poet. B. What are the characteristics of the stage? In this stage, the boy goes to school with his bag. His face is shining. Third one, how does the boy go to school? The boy goes to school with his bag unwillingly. He moves towards the school as slowly as a snail. Fourth one, which figure of speech has been employed in the second line? Simile is employed in the second line. Moving on to B. Then a soldier full of strange oaths and bearded like a pot, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble repetition even in the cannon's mouth. Question 1. What is the soldier ready to do? The soldier is ready to quarrel. Quarrel here means argument. Second one, explain bubble repetition. A bubble means empty and it stays only for a short time. Reputation also is as short-lived as a bubble. Moving on to the third question. What are the distinguishing features of this stage? In this stage, the soldier is full of promises. He has a beard like a leopard. He tries to gain honor and he is quick to take up any argument. Even at the risk of his life, he tries to achieve reputation, which is as short-lived as bubble. Moving on to C. And then the justice in fair round belly with good cape and line, with eyes silver and beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. First question, whom does justice refer to? Justice refers to man in his fifth stage. Second one, describe his appearance. He has a fair belly. He has become fat from eating chicken. He has a serious look and a formal beard. Third one, how does he behave with the people around him? He behaves with the people around him as a learned man. And fourth question, what does he do to show his wisdom? To show his wisdom, he quotes many proverbs and modern instances. Dear students, we have finished the book bag exercises.